If you I if Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Chelsea. This is Trendy Chelsea, my channel. I also have a blog called trendychelsea.com. You guys can find the link to that in the bio if you want to check it out. Today, I'm really excited because I have a favorites video for you guys. I've really been wanting to do a favorites video for a little while now because I have so many things that I'm just in love with. So the way that I'm going to do this, I'm going to break it up into four categories. The first category will be fashion, which I think I have four items for. Second category is beauty. I also have four items for beauty. And then I have random and then music. So I guess this, I don't even know. Maybe this is for the spring. What date is it? Because some of these have only been my favorites for like the past couple weeks. So maybe I should make this like a June favorites video. So the first category is fashion. And my first thing is these jeans from, I think they're from PacSun. Yeah, they're from PacSun. And they just have these cut up ends. So, and also you can tell that they're like cut at different levels, if you can tell there. And they are also high waisted. They're from the Kendall and Kylie collection. Literally, you guys, these are like the perfect mom jeans, and I've been wearing them. I think I seriously wore them for like 3 weeks straight. Told all my roommates, like, make sure I am buried in these jeans. They are just so flattering, and I literally love them so much. I think they were part of the pack, you know, PacSun does that sale. It's like buy one, get two free. So they were part of that, literally, and they were a little bit pricey. I think they were like $60. So they were definitely pricey, not normally would I spend that much on a pair of jeans, but seriously guys, these were so worth it. Next in my favorites for clothing is this denim jacket, which actually I DIY'd. If you guys have been following my blog since the fall time, you might have seen I did a blog post on this actual jacket, and I had done patches all around it, and it was basically just a tutorial on how to like DIY your own jacket and make it trendy. But I actually ended up redoing this one maybe a few weeks ago and just concentrating all the patches onto the back right here. So yeah, there's definitely just, they're very like a little more cluttered right here, which I kind of like that look actually. And it's got like all my favorite things. It's got a cactus, a rose, pizza. So it just like love how it looks all concentrated in the back like that. And then on the front, it still has, it had the sunflower on it when I originally made it, and it still is there. And then I also have a little pizza pin on the collar and a little cactus pin right here. But yeah, I love it. It's getting a little too hot to wear a denim jacket, especially this big. This, oh, the jacket, by the way, is from Salvation Army. It was from the men's section. So like, thumbs up for thrifting, because seriously, some of my favorite clothing pieces have been thrifted. And sometimes I DIY them, sometimes I just leave them as they are, and seriously, sometimes my favorite pieces. So my next favorite fashion piece is these shoes. These are from Charlotte Russe. They're just little black short booties. They've got short little gold heels. They're kind of clunky, I guess. I don't think clunky is the word. And they're open toe, and literally these are just the cutest things. I feel like they go with like jeans, like distressed jeans, or I don't know, maybe I pair them with a dress. I'm not really sure. I don't think a dress. Who knows? Yeah, they're seriously just so cute. And my next fashion favorite has been turtleneck t-shirts. This one's from Brandy Melville. I actually, you know what, I got this in Rome at the Brandy Melville in Rome. So I'm wondering, is Brandy Melville Europe the same? Do they have the same stuff as Brandy Melville in the States? I don't know. Let me know in the comments if you know if they have the same stuff. But they had these turtleneck t-shirts, and I have this one, and then I have also have it in black. But I like it. It's like really kind of oversized, but then it has this turtleneck for like kind of a little bit of a fitted look, but the sleeves are pretty big and a pretty wide fit, so it hangs kind of loosely. But I really, really have been loving turtleneck tees. So moving on to beauty favorites. My first favorite is this one. And I know I'm not original and this isn't new, and I probably first heard about this Batiste, maybe, dry shampoo from, I think, Bethany Moda in like a YouTube video, probably at the beginning of high school, literally. But this, like, who cares, right? Like, this dry shampoo is still the bomb. It, like, is such a game changer in terms of, like, how much you have to wash your hair. So, I use this religiously, basically, is what I'm trying to say. My next beauty favorite is this product right here. I don't know how to say this name, so I'm not gonna try. But basically it says Hair Serum, the Arabic Secret of the Olive Oil, Restores and Something Shine. Revives Shine. So I've had this for a little while. I used it a lot, I want to say, at the end of high school, and then I think I might have used it too much and my hair started to get a little more heavy and greasy looking. So I stopped using it, but I recently started again. And basically if you just apply a little drop of this and run it through your hair while your hair is wet right after you get out of the shower, it makes your hair so soft once it's dried. Like, just like your fingers just run through so much more smoothly. I literally love this stuff. So my next beauty favorite is not actually this Revlon ColorStay, what is this called? Translucent powder, that's what it's called. I've actually really just been loving the trend of baking your translucent powder on, and I've just been using this one. I don't know, it's fine, it's cheap, I think it's from Walmart. Basically, baking is the trend where you pack your translucent powder on your face where you want your skin to be pretty light and leave it there while you do the rest of your makeup, and then you brush it off. And you look pretty silly when you're doing it. I feel like I was like a ghost. Does this video look really blue to you? I feel like it looks really like cold colors. But anyways, I've been really loving the trend of baking. And I've just been using this Revlon one. And my last beauty favorite is this Ceche Vede Dry Fast Top Coat. I don't know if I said it right, but one of my roommates in Rome actually introduced this to me, and I seriously, like, I probably won't get my nails done at a salon again for a while because this stuff dries so quickly and it's not tacky at all. And it doesn't like prevent chipping or anything, but like, it's really good stuff, and I've been doing my nails constantly, and it saves me a lot of money to do them at home. So I've really been loving this. I think it was like $9 at Walmart. So now on to random favorites. My first random favorite is this White Barn Vermont Mint Scented Candle. This is what it looks like. It's just from Bath & Body Works. It smells so good. Like, and I just love how it looks. It's like decor and like functionality in one. Okay, don't make fun of me for this next one, but my second random favorite is these cactus plates. These are from Walmart. Oh, correction, that dry coat is from Target, not from Walmart. I don't think they have it at Walmart. Literally, they're just so cute, and now that I have my own house, I can justify like spending money on like plates and cups and like mugs and cute stuff like that that I really wouldn't have had a place to put in my home with my parents. So I got four, there's only three of them right here, but four of these cactus plates. Seriously guys, eating breakfast is just so much more exciting when there's cactus on your plates, and I love them! So my last random favorite is this little guy right here. His name's Jeffrey. He's the first plant I've bought as a self-proclaimed adult. And so far, he looks like he's still alive. I'm not really great at remembering to water plants, but yeah. Also, this vase, I think it was like $8 from Marshall's, and I love like the marbled look of it. I might actually go back and get a second one to have a second plant in my room. But yep, this is Jeffrey. Please pray for him. He's still alive now, but you know, check back in a week, we'll see. But my last category, oh, by the way, this is my cactus phone case. If you can't tell, I'm obsessed with cactuses. This actually would probably be another random favorite. I got it at Charlotte Russe for I think like $4, and I love it. It's also like, you know, you would think it's impossible to lose your phone with a case like this on it, but I did lose my phone for like 24 hours a couple weeks ago. And it turns out the whole time it was like underneath the purse on my bed, so. But anyways, the last category is music favorites. So I just want to show you guys a few of the songs that I've been listening to nonstop. I'm kind of at the point where I'm like stopping to listen to it because I've like played it like on repeat for a few weeks now. But this Italian song, Senza Pagare, VS T-Pain, oh, VS, oh my gosh, it's, oh! VS in Italian means featuring. I didn't know that. This makes so much sense. Basically, this is an Italian song I'll play for you guys in a second, but literally in love with the song. It has Fedez in it. which like Fedez, I feel like I kind of fell in love with him a little bit while I was in Italy, and apparently he's kind of for a younger crowd, but I don't really care. I don't really understand any of it, but I really... Anyways, this is the song. Da ragazzina era normale non avere soldi. E prima di ordinare e controllare il portafogli. Professor X, Batman, Iron Man e Iron Fist. Supereroi ma pieni di quattrini. Per la verità c'è omertà come il crimine. Senza regole. Come le ragazze con il grilletto. So I would say my next favorite has been, let's see, my next favorite has low-key also been by Fedez. I don't know how to say the name of this one. I'm gonna try it though. Favore ma non posto. It's by J-Ax and Fedez. I'll play this one. Io vi chiedo pardon, ma non seguo il bon ton. E che a cena devo avere sempre in mano un iPhone. Il cane di Chiara Ferragni al Papillon di Vuitton. Ed un collare con più glitter di una giacca di Elton John. Oh, vorrei, ma non posso. E ancora un'altra estate arriverà. E compreremo un altro esame all'università. E poi un tuffo nel mare, nazional popolare. La voglia di cantare tanto non ci basterà. My next music favorite has been a slight switch of gears. It's called Drinking Problem by Midland. It's a country song. If you know me, you know I'm a huge country music fan. I grew up on country music and it's the majority, I would say, of what I listen to, but this one's been popular recently and I really, really love to jam to it. One more night, one more down, one more round. First one in, last one out, giving this town lots to talk about. But they don't know, but they don't know. People say I got a drinking problem, that ain't no reason to stop. Let's see, what else have I been listening to? I really like Justin's new song with David Guetta, the 2U song, but I do feel like that one's gonna get old kind of fast just because it has like one of those beats that can kind of get old. I would say another favorite of mine recently has been Runaway by Gary Allen. It's kind of, I think it's, oh, it's from 1999, so it's a little bit old, but it's just a jam, man. Like, I love it. So that completes my favorites video for June. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you guys aren't already subscribed, be sure to click the red box down below. So I guess that's it for today. I will see you guys soon. Please keep commenting things that you want to see on my channel. And I will see you guys next time. Bye!